Congratulations. You did it. I'm excited and honored to be here today to celebrate one of the most memorable moments of your life, and also to share with you what I have learned about life. I want to give you a few practical, pragmatic ideas for how you can prosper. I remember when I got my first graduate degree, I was so happy that I could say bye-bye to 5 months. No more term papers, no AI studies, right? But later I found back in school for another master's degree, and a few years later, an MBA. Now, I'm not saying that you need 3 graduate degrees like I did. Well, maybe in your thoughts about that. I'm actually just giving you my first message. Make learning a priority in your life. After you graduate, and always. Why? Because you're living a world that is moving faster and becoming smaller than ever. I found it fascinating. The pace of the world is determined by the speed of the information exchange. Today, with internet and cell phone, 1 year feels like 3 years in your parents' generation. The only way you will stay at the forefront of technology and thrive is to never stop learning. When I look back, I sense that at least 80% of knowledge I'm using today, I learned after graduating. Knowledge about marketing, sales, management, and finance. When I graduated from this engineering school, I never heard of the word internet firewall, not to mention how to build it. Only a few years later, at NetScreen, we built the best firewalls in the world, simply by continuous learning. Learning is the engine that drives innovation. Learning throughout lifetime seems like a scary task, isn't it? The good news is, the more you learn, the longer you learn, the more you enjoy it. Today, I'm still curious about so many new things. Curiosity gave me the desire to learn, and learning has made so much fun in my life. Now my second message. In a world that moves so much faster, you also need to adapt yourself very quickly to the environment around yourself as it changes and as you evolve. I have attended a total of 12 schools in my life. As a child, it was hard for me to transfer to a new school. At first, I always felt sad, being a stranger among kids who all knew each other. I always had to make myself available and introduce myself and find ways not to be ignored. Only years later, did I see how this taught me to quickly adapt to new environments and make me more resilient. For 20 years, I've worked in different companies, industries, countries, and cultures. I've learned developing the ability to adapt will give us a big competitive advantage. And it will also make us happy by making more friends. A big part of adapting is to embrace diversity, which is crucial in today's business environment. When we started NetScreen, we built a team of Americans, Australians, Chinese, Indian, Koreans, and many others with different diverse backgrounds. This helped us penetrate the world market much more easily, more than 100 countries in a short period of 6 years. You are lucky. USC is one of the most culturally diverse universities in the world. I heard 75% of you are international students. You learned from your classmates to understand and respect different cultures. What a gift. You are now well positioned to lead the next wave of global transformation. Well, here is my next message. While you learn and adapt, you will also need to develop the ability to make decisions quickly. quickly and decisively. Why? In today's world, companies compete on speed. A fast company is better than a large company every time. Don't wait too long. You will never have complete information. Decide and move. Remember the dot-com burst in 2001? The telecom carrier market was almost dead. At NetScreen, soon after we sensed the market change, we quickly decided to shift our market focus from telecom carriers to enterprises. At the time, it wasn't an obvious choice, but we moved faster than our incumbent competitors. They were still heavily. Soon, we became the industry leader. Making decisions can be hard sometimes. Back then in 1997, leaving Intel to start NetScreen was a risky and therefore a tough decision for me. I couldn't sleep well for a week. I would leave more than $1 million worth of stock options on the table without knowing if I could raise money or even I could have a job if we failed to raise the money. I knew there was big risk ahead with our new company, our new baby. But I also knew we could have missed the best timing if we kept away. I took the risk and moved on, and the rest is history. So don't be afraid of making mistakes, and don't be afraid of taking risks. Make the decisions that you can with the information you have, and just move and adjust. Now that you've got some pragmatic ideas for how to thrive, let's talk about what really motivates you. Some of you may feel unclear about your future. No clear goals or dreams, or even if you have a dream, you may feel it's too remote or too unrealistic. Honestly, I had similar feeling when I was an undergrad. Until one day, I picked up a book, Fire in the Valley. It is about the story of the Silicon Valley and those brave young entrepreneurs like Bill Gates and Steve Jobs. This book truly enlightened me. At that moment, I started my dream. To be an entrepreneur, and better yet, to be the cradle of the entrepreneurship Silicon Valley. I have to say, back then this dream was very distant. At that time in China, most of the businesses were state-owned, and the word entrepreneur was not even in the dictionary. Coming abroad was also unrealistic in 1985, since my family couldn't afford it at all. Well, in the following years, I set up objectives and made progress step by step. Although the first few objectives were still far from my dream, but it had helped me get closer. I started my first business right after I read the book. We printed computerized image on t-shirts. Pretty glamorous, right? There was no digital camera at that time. In the mid-80s, with an analog camera, we converted pictures to digital. At that time, blazing fast, 5 megahertz, 8088 processor, 8-bit process, we printed images. Then with a big eye, we put images on t-shirts. Well, my parents were quite worried then. They said I shouldn't spend money on the business. Instead, I should save money for my wedding. Actually, I didn't even have a girlfriend then. My mom told me to save 20 RMB, approximately $2 every month. Sorry, Mom, I didn't listen to you. Within a year, I was able to make 10,000 RMB a month, more than 30 times the sum of my parents' salary. At this moment, I started supporting my family, and as you can imagine, my parents stopped worrying and begging. After my first business success, I continued to pursue my dream to be an entrepreneur in Silicon Valley. I came to the States as a graduate student, first in the East Coast, then transferred to USC because it was closer to Silicon Valley. Well, of course, also because USC is better than UCLA. My wife isn't here. She actually was a student at UCLA. Later, I took a lower-paying job at Intel than my other options on hand, because it was in Silicon Valley. Finally, another 4 years later, I started my own company in Silicon Valley. Now my message is to you. You want to have a dream, and you must relentlessly and persistently pursue your dream. It doesn't matter where you start and how far away. As long as you keep moving toward the right direction, with step-by-step objectives and progress, you will get closer and closer. And one day, you will realize your dream. All right, now you have your education. Nice work. What matters now is how you resolve to learn, adapt, make decisions, and take risks. It's your clarity about your dream. And it's how you relentlessly pursue your dream. I have all the confidence on you, and I want to tell you what I have done, you can do. And I cannot wait to see you live up to the full true measure of your potential. The world is yours. Go get it. Congratulations, and thank you.